What's up, everyone, and welcome to another Bitcoin quick market update. So let's start off here on the weekly time frame. Right now, we had that inside bar last week. The bulls are trying to make a push above the previous weekly high at 52705 on this exchange. If they do, that will lead to some expansion, because whenever we get tightening up in price on an inside bar on a high time frame, we usually get expansion from there. That will also validate this low as a hidden bullish divergence here, with a lower low on the RSI but a higher low in price. So the bulls are trying to make a move there. Let's go down to the daily time frame and see what we got here. Right now on the daily time frame, we are currently right on this gray resistance level right here, trying to push through it. This is the third test of this now. If today we get a close like this, where, you know, our candle is still operating below the gray zone, I'll like a move down below here to the blue area right here, because if we look on the 12-hour time frame, this is a really juicy setup in my opinion, where we are currently we changed the trend on the 12-hour time frame with our low, high, higher low, higher high here. And we didn't quite test this black candle right here, which is our main support level here. But if we do end up coming back into that zone over the next, I would say, couple days here, that is gonna be where I am looking to long. And at minimum, we will be targeting 53.3. But realistically, if this ends up being a inverse head and shoulders pattern, the ultimate target for this will be up here around 61K. So that would be about a 25% gain if we were to go into that level, which, you know, is yet to be seen. But if we push through this gray zone and close two candles above that, that'll be a very good sign that, yes, in fact, this probably will end up pushing up to at least 61,000. So what I would look for here is for the price to come down into this purple zone. I will bazooka long this baby. We'll come through this gray zone, close two candles above here, retest that for another long entry, and then we'll go up to the moonshot for the bulls to get their Lamborghinis. And so that is currently what I'm watching for on Bitcoin. Let's look at Ethereum real quick, just as a guide to why I think that this might be the case that we are going to go down. If we look at the 12-hour time frame, we have this long doji candle right here at the top of a run-up, which usually signifies indecision in the market. Couple this with the fact that we're in a daily, this gray zone right here, daily resistance zone, and then a 12-hour resistance zone inside of that, which we tested right here as support but then closed through. So this should act as resistance. The minimum push down will be the previous 12-hour low here, which is at 1668. I would imagine that we push down into this gray zone right here. That will be our support level that I will look to long. The main level that I'm targeting is this 8-hour level. If we end up pushing all the way down to that, that is a nice risk reward ratio. If we look at that real quick, we can see that a long position there with our stop loss below, we can do this low right here. A push, you know, if we're targeting the inverse head and shoulders pattern, that's going to take us up to about 2022. That's a risk to reward of about 5.76. That's a really, really juicy setup there for me personally. I really like this trade, especially because of the fact that if we look at this on the 12-hour time frame, it would be perfectly confluent with like our push above the neckline right here. You could even consider this the neckline. And we still closed both of these candles above that. So usually when you do that, you retest that, and right here we had our other shoulder, so a retest of that zone would be the ultimate position there to long. So that's kind of what I'm looking for here on Bitcoin and Ethereum. I hope that was helpful for you. If you like this video, give it a like, subscribe down below so you can receive updates on future videos, and I will talk to you all soon.